Hi there, my name's Flight Attendant James Elliott and I'm the VDT, the Volunteer Development Team Lead for the Cadet Portal project, working directly with Headquarters Air Cadets. This video today is just to show you some of the new functionality in Cadet Portal for the production of a TG21 consent form. So lots of people have been asking us, will Cadet Portal output a TG21 form for us electronically that the cadet can just print, get signed and hand into the squadron, and we've been working on that for you. So if I just log into the Cadet Portal, we'll hit the sign in screen and off we go, logging in through Microsoft 365 as before, as per the first demonstration video that we did for you, and it's currently bouncing off to Cadet Portal at the moment. We're now into the system, so if we go to the events area and we look at the upcoming events that are coming on the squadron, I can look at this particular event here that I know the cadet has put their name down for already. So if I click on this one, I'll be able to see that this cadet is attending the event because I've already clicked it, and there's this banner saying that, and we can see here the TG21 consent form. If I go back to the events list though, and if I look at an event that they haven't signed up for yet, so if I was looking at this method of instruction course for instance, I can click on it, and when I get there I can add my name. You can see that the link for the TG21 isn't present until the cadet actually adds their name to the list. So if I add my name to this one now, the page refreshes and we can see there's a TG21 consent form, and if I click this now, it'll open a new screen on the form. And what we've done, we've basically rebuilt the form through Cadet Portal, and it's outputting just as a website essentially. So what you can then do is actually just print directly from this screen. So if I press Control P on my web browser, I can see here it's going to print, and you'll be pleased to see that the form actually prints on a single piece of paper, not on two pages, which is good. What will also happen is the declaration at the bottom here will change depending on whether the cadet is under 18 or over 18. So if they're under 18, it requires them to get their parents or guardian signature. If they're over 18, they're obviously able to sign it themselves. So that's what we've done so far. And you can see these fields are starting to fill in. So we've got the activity, the location, the dates from and to, and the names and so forth. There are parts of the form that won't be filled in automatically. For instance, national insurance number isn't a field on SMS, so isn't there. And things like the doctor's details, that's not on SMS either. That's basically how the system's working at the moment. So if I just take you through that again, so from the event, if I take my name off this list and then add myself back onto it again, we can then get the completed TG21. So hopefully that's going to reduce admin burden at the squadron level and make it easier for cadets to access the correct consent form that's already pre-filled in for them, so they just print it and take it to the event. And that's it. Thank you very much for your time, and if you've got any questions or queries, please don't hesitate to get in touch. Thanks very much.